it's Danny Kingad in the red trunks, Muhamad Haidar in the black trunks.
Kingad's got an unconventional stance. He's keeping his left hand very low. He has a almost erratic footwork that he's debuting here. So he's really, I think the nerves might be a little bit, this is a big stage for him to be on right now, but he's so excited and he's so pumped to be here tonight. Kingad, on the other hand, looks very composed, relaxed, stalking forward, just kind of controlling the center of that cage.
Certainly a controlled start, as you say. Not much action yet, both very, very cautious, not wanting to make an error, and it's no surprise that Olivier Cost asks them to step up the pace a little bit, and they respond straight away.
See, Steve, there's that crushing leg kick that Kingad likes to throw. You typically see the wushu fighters from Team Lakay throwing that push kick. But he likes to change it up and attack the legs. Nice double leg takedown by Kingad right there as he puts Haidar on his back, but he pops right back up and he goes right back down.
Heavy takedowns as well. The whole cage seemed to vibrate. Really have got a noisy crowd here, even in the early part of the evening.
Yeah, Kingad's real popular with the Filipino fans.
Any fighter that comes from the famed Team Lakay really kind of takes on the weight of the nation on their shoulders, and they support that weight very well indeed.
You can see Muhamad Haidar trying to slide out, but right now the fighters are dry. They haven't worked up a sweat yet, so it's really easy just to kind of hold on to your opponent and control them. So you really have to demonstrate really good technique in these early stages of this round where everybody is so fresh and so strong.
Olivier Cost will be on top of Danny Kingad to make sure he works to some kind of a finish. At the moment, he's using his elbows and his forearm to try and create some damage.
See, Kingad just got easily let, you know, slide up on the top, and he's just dropping the punches down on top.
And
really
it's not
going
to last much longer, Mitch. That's it. You could see that Muhamad Haidar was intent only on covering up. There was no way he was going to throw any punches back from that position.
This should be a very interesting striking battle. We've got the wushu style of Kingad versus the Muay Thai skills of Toquero.
Toquero has 7 TKOs on his record, so a very dangerous man. Kingad may well be unbeaten, but by far the more inexperienced of the two fighters. And this means that if Kingad can get the W here, it's a big stepping stone for him.
Ooh, that was a beautiful transition. Toquero went after the leg after catching the kick, and Kingad was able to roll it and use the caught leg to end up with the... It looked like he threw him with his leg.
It was extremely unorthodox and
that
high-paced.
That was beautiful. Rich Franklin looks baffled next to me. He has no idea what that was. Something out of a kung fu movie. Beautifully done. Kingad on top now, trying to slide past the half guard a little bit, but just inching Toquero up against the cage there, possibly looking to dish out some ground and pound. Steps over. Looks like he's trying to get into mount. Looks like it could be a guillotine setting up there. The Team Lakay fighters have spent so much time improving their wrestling and their grappling game, and we've seen it. And they've just grown by leaps and bounds. Every time these fighters get into the cage, they're showing an improved skill set.
They've had an absolutely tremendous 2016, and it's ended up with Edward Folayang as the lightweight champion. It started with Kevin Belling on losing his tilt at Bibiano Fernandez, but it's ended so well for them. Folayang beating Shinya Aoki, giving everyone, not just Filipinos, but everyone, that realization that no matter how much of an underdog you are, there's always a chance if you get your game plan right and execute your skills perfectly on the night.
Half guard shown here by Toquero, and he's really got to try to get away from having his back flat against the mat there. Kingad's doing the right thing by pressuring him like that and also keeping his head on that side of the body so Toquero can't turn onto his side and start maybe shrimping away out of that. See, he's got the pressure on the hip from the legs, then he's got the head pressure and the shoulder pressure pinning Toquero in that position. Toquero wants to start to shrimp out and move his back towards the center of the cage and possibly start to get out of this position, because Kingad's doing a little bit of damage here. He's landing some strikes. Kingad's trying to push down on that knee so he can pass the knee through the leg gap there to end up in a mounted position.
Very limited with what he can do with that left leg. Toquero's constantly trying to wrap his legs around that, although he's escaped it now.
Now he's got side control now.
Elbows to the body from Kingad. 21 years old.
Yeah, we've seen so many fighters here tonight that are just starting their MMA career, and really their potential is just, it has no bounds to see how good these kids can get, especially when you have training partners like Benario, like, you know, the champion Foleon, Kevin Bellegong. You have so much talent around there up in Team Lakay that these kids are so young, they're just gonna grow every single time they get in the cage. And fighting a guy, the experience of Toquero is only gonna add to Danny's overall game.
And I've seen those guys run up and down the hills in Baguio. No wonder they've got such huge quads and tremendous stamina.
Watch out, headbutt, watch out.
The stamina, training elevation up there in Baguio is just gonna do so much for your capability when it comes to the conditioning aspect, to grind out these fights and to push these fights into deep water. You gotta bet that they're gonna have the advantage. Good ground control shown by Kingad here. He's transitioned into an armbar.
Oh, and it looks good. He's tapped straight away.
Beautiful.
So Kingad isn't having any of that.
Go!
But probably the biggest problem is the man facing him. Muhamad Haidar has skills. He has speed and athleticism. Great emotion and passion, as you saw earlier on as well.
We've got, again, Bali MMA against Team Lakay. Two powerhouses out here in the Asian region.
A lot of people pick this one out as one of the great matchups of the night.
Ooh, nice left hand from Kingad.
He's got some speed, isn't he?
Yeah,
little bit
he
of
does.
Ferocity. Whoa, talk about speed. That counter right hand from Muhamad Haidar was blinding. You can already see that these two are really up for this. Keep your eyes on it. Now that was a kick.
Sounded low.
Oh. There was a lot of upper left thigh in that, but I'm not disputing that there was some central connection, and that means that there's a little bit of trouble.
The skin and the cup sound completely different. I think that was a little bit of both.
Ladies and gentlemen, injury time. The fighter has 5 minutes.
And
yeah.
Top.
Clearly below the belt. Not in the horrific area, but. As you can see there, every fighter adjudged to have been the recipient of a foul kick is allowed 5 minutes for a medical examination and recovery. And Brandon, that's valuable, isn't it?
Both of these guys, yes, sir. You need that time to get your brains back together and get back into the fight.
And it looks like we're cut well inside the 5 minutes that's allowed. And these two get back to work.
Kingad's keeping that right hand nice and high, protecting his guard, but also getting ready to fire.
It looked like there was a little clash of heads there for a moment, but look at the speed these two are exhibiting when they're in the pocket. Oh, tremendous knee to the midriff from Kingad and a left hand there. These two are moving at tremendous pace.
Kingad able to drag the fight to the ground. Now he's in side control here. Muhamad Haidar's trying to get back into guard, does a nice job of getting that knee through and kind of stopping Kingad from getting into full side control. He's able to see how he's keeping that knee nice and tight to the body of Kingad, and he's kind of moving with him. As Kingad tries to pass into side control, Haidar's doing the right thing.
Both of these two are fantastic. Well, they have tremendous futures in front of them, so to see them meet each other so early in terms of their age is a fascinating one.
Oh, transitions right into mount. Now he's got that high mount position, dropping some elbows. Haidar's gonna try to scoot out the back, but good pressure from Kingad.
Flush on the face, those elbows, didn't they? Very damaging indeed. He's trying again, but that was more with the forearm. And there's the elbow to the temple.
it's more than just the shorts and the Team Lakay logo. This guy looks very similar to our champion, Edward Foley, who we're gonna see later tonight defend his title.
Knees to the head, and Ayman is taking a lot of punishment in that area now from forearms and elbows and knees. This is not where he wants to be. He does his best work on his feet with those tremendously quick hands of his.
He's keeping the hand nice and tight, trying to pin down the arm. Now he's got in the crucifix position. This is a bad spot for Ayman to be in. He's got to create some movement.
The crucifix position and the crowd behind him. And now the back of Muhamad Ayman. No immediate danger there with that arm around the throat, but he's tossed down.
Big takedown. This kid has some very innovative takedowns.
He's a strong boy, isn't he? There's quite a difference in torso between these two.
The core strength of Kingad to throw people around the way that he does is extremely impressive. Kingad's top control is something special. He's able to just smother his opponents and just drop in ground and pound on him. Ayman's trying to walk the cage, trying to circle out. Might be able to escape out the back door, but Kingad's got a pretty tight grip on him. Here looks to be, doesn't have the arm in. Might be threatening inverted triangle possibly there, but Kingad just staying in north and south. Dropping some knees down. He's got a few submissions from here. There are a few chokes he could possibly lock up in Kimura, but this is Kingad's specialty. He likes the ground and pound. He likes to manhandle his opponents and drop shots on them.
Final 15 seconds of this opening round. It's been an absolute thriller.
Good job by Ayman to get back up to his feet and to finish his round. Standing in the middle of the cage as they exchange heavy shots.
What a round that was. Five furious minutes, and the crowd, I'm sure, cannot wait to get into the second round.
Here we go. That was a nice left hand by Kingad. Ayman tried to get up on top, but Kingad was just able to muscle his way on top. And that's where the round was pretty much dictated. He was able to get into side control, drop heavy ground and pound. Let's go to our guest judge, the world heavyweight champion, Brandon Vera, to get his input on that round.
Were very, very aggressive. The biggest difference between both of them was the ground control of Kingad. He was on the ground controlling the whole time, dropping elbows and knees to the head while holding him down in side control. Biggest difference, first round aggression. Let's see it this second round.
What a prospect. More time with these two in the cage. I love the first 5 minutes. Danny Kingad against Muhamad Ayman. The Philippines against Malaysia on this noisy night, this action-packed, atmospheric evening at the Mall of Asia Arena.
Ayman immediately starts pushing forward, knows he might be in a slight bit of a hole from that first round, so he's trying to get back into it by pushing forward and see how he's controlling the cage. Now, Kingad's got to get his back away from the cage, kind of staying stationary, but he immediately circles out. Good footwork from Danny Kingad.
Figures that Ayman has to really concentrate now. He's got to do his best work when he's standing up here. That's where he is really impressive. Kingad seems to be the stronger of the two on the deck, and that's where he wants to put this fight right now.
Kingad slides under the punches to shoot in for the double, transition to a single. Now he's starting to suck the hips away from the cage because Ayman's going to want to start to stand back up. So Kingad's going to slowly start to pull the hips away from the cage so Ayman can't pop back up. Now he's starting to turn the corner. Good cage control from Danny Kingad. Ooh, nice step over there from Danny Kingad. Ayman had half guard, but Kingad was able to step out. Now he's trying to slide the knee back in.
across the stomach of Kingad. Now he's got a high guard. Kingad's just smothering him, though. Muhamad's not able to just get anything moving. He can't create any kind of scrambles. Kingad's got to be one of the stronger guys at this weight. Team Lakay is known for their unique strength and conditioning programs. They like to throw bricks around, carry bales of hay, jumping over cars.
Elbows to the side of Muhamad Haidar's head.
See, now he's got an inverted triangle here. See how he's one arm is inside?
Yeah.
And he's got, there's a submission here, but Kingad's trying, looks like he's trying to muscle out of it.
He's gonna use those strong legs to lift himself up if he can, but he's locked in there, isn't he?
That's a bad position for Danny Kingad to be in, because Iman could hold this for probably a couple of minutes, but he's not really on top. Oh,
loosening
look at Kingad muscling his way out. But he readjusts, but he's got to kind of pop his hips over to the side so he can get a little bit deeper into that triangle.
No breath. Jammed up against the cage wall. Yuji Shimada tells Muhamad Haidar not to grip the wall with his toes.
Action, work to finish.
Work to finish, he also says.
Iman has a very bad position on an Americana-type grip there on his arm. You can see the arms are interlaced, and it's kind of bending. I mean, he has possibility to crank his Kingad's right arm out, but look at that muscle just
and suddenly the forearms
it out.
Come down, and then more heavy blows. Iman's taken quite a bit of punishment in that area from that source.
Wow, look at the strength of Danny Kingad. Pops the head. Now he has got head control, presses that shoulder into the chin there of Muhamad Haidar. That was a good hit. He tried to bridge out, create a little bit of space. He's trying to turn. Nice and tight from Danny Kingad. He's trying to possibly lace in a darce choke here. Yep, that's what he's looking for. Darce choke. Now he's got, so once he gets that hand across the bicep, that's a bad spot for Muhamad Haidar.
This crowd roaring their encouragement for the Filipino.
Oh, look at the heart of Muhamad Haidar, just to grit and turn into deeper into the choke to pop his head out.
Directly above us here at cage side, knees to the chest from Kingad, oohs and ahs from the crowd here at cage side as we enter the final minute of the second round, a three-round contest, 15 minutes for these two to impress the judges or finish it early. And now Haidar has Kingad's back. What can he do with it?
Muhamad Haidar is a little bit high, and Kingad's trying to drop his hips down. He could possibly do it. He could take him down, or he could just jump onto the back of Danny Kingad. Almost a takedown, almost a sacrifice takedown to end up on top.
Every move is being greeted by this audience with oohs and ahs.
But the difference is the strength of Danny Kingad. He's able to just out-muscle all the positions that Muhamad Haidar's trying to get into.
He's got that thick, muscular upper body, hasn't he? And he's working to his advantage here. We're about the end of the second round. 10 minutes down, five to go, potentially.
Wow, impressive round there for Danny Kingad to end the round on top. Here's that Americana that was trying to be attempted, but just kind of a lost cause there. Kingad able to drop in some elbows. Let's go to the One World Champion, Brandon Vera, for his take on that round.
More from the same from Kingad. He's been controlling him on the ground, throwing knees, throwing elbows, just punishing Haidar on the ground. He's winning first and second round on ground control with strikes. It's amazing to watch this guy work, and his strength, his tenacity is awesome. Those boys at Team Lakay don't play around.
Brandon, does Muhamad Haidar have a shot?
He has to stay on the feet. He has to keep it on his feet if he wants a chance to win this fight.
There you have it, Steve.
Every round starts on the feet, and that will be to Muhamad Haidar's advantage initially. How long will that status survive, though? That's the question. How long before he gets dragged down into the swamp, into the sinking sand that Kingad provides?
Let's go final.
Both fighters looking really fresh here in the final round.
like Brandon Vera said, Ayman's got to keep this fight on his feet, so he might want to not push forward that intense pressure that he's had in the first two rounds. He's really got to create his distance, some lateral movement to keep moving. And punching may be his best weapon here, because he throws those kicks. Kingad might catch the kick, take him down.
Spinning back fist.
You know, this, or I'm just trying thinking, something really fancy to expose him to a possible takedown.
I'm just thinking the pace of this fight. And here they are at the beginning of the third round, still looking very, very fresh. The weight-cutting experience at ONE Championship, which incorporates hydration very importantly, means that they are fresh as they possibly can be here. And that's why we're seeing high-quality mixed martial arts right through to the end of the 15th minute.
To have zero fighters dehydrated, I mean, it changes the game completely. If you don't have to worry about cutting weight, you can just focus on your best performance ever, it creates an entirely different game.
Kingad pushing his man, pressing him up against the cage. Is he faking that, or is he? He looks as if he's about to collapse.
I think that's his real feeling. I think he just, there's a little bit of frustration there because, you know, the spinning back fist led to this position. He, you know, it's hard to be, you know, when you're that caught up in the moment to try stuff like that. A little bit of frustration for Muhamad Ayman to end up back down in the same position where he spent most of this fight.
And that'll be a big disappointment to him because the work he does when standing up can be quite electrifying at times. Showed that in his last fight, showed it in the early moments of this fight. But since then, it's been all about Kingad's strength and technique and control.
Yeah, I think the control is it, and the strength is giving him the ability to have this kind of control. He's just so dominant in all the positions. He's able to muscle his way when technique kind of fails him a bit. He's able to just outstrength his opponent. Outstrength, is that a word? I don't think it is. But he's just
muscle?
Out-muscle, that's a much better word, Steve. That's why you're the journalist. Look at this positioning. Like right now, he's got the left hand on the hip, right hand on the head. Muhamad Ayman can't go anywhere.
Less than 2.5 minutes in this third and final round. Proficient use of the elbows from both of these guys in this contest.
It's that improved Team Lakay wrestling. Their entire team has leveled up in that one area.
They've had. They have just really rocked it.
We got a triangle. We got a triangle by Muhamad Ayman. He's a bit more of a face crank. He's just kind of cranking on the armbar now.
He could turn everything around here. He's got to push that neck back and pull the arm into him. He's not getting that kind of torque yet.
He's got to get a little bit tighter. Kingad's on his way out. He's a bit high, but he's close.
What an opportunity for Muhamad Ayman to turn this around, though. But the fans willing on the Filipino.
That's it. They're the elbows. That's going to do more damage.
That'll distract him.
Precisely. That's it. If he keeps dropping the elbows, maybe he can pull in and readjust this triangle. It's tight now. See, now he's starting to inch his way out. The head's a bit tight, so it's not quite the same pressure
still
in that arm.
Working on it.
See how his elbow's just a bit out of the leverage range? He can't quite create the hip motion to create that armbar pressure.
Yuji Shimada calling for action.
This jam-packed crowd is on their feet, rooting their fighter, Danny Kingad, out of this horrible position that he's in right now.
No question, they're making a lot of noise here. Capacity crowd at the Mall of Asia Arena. 20,000 people all night long building up to our main event, the world title fight, but they are getting their money's worth in this fight alone.
I like how Muhamad Ayman tried to grab under the leg of Danny Kingad. But this is Kingad's on his way out. He's out.
Listen to the noise in this arena. That's what they wanted to see. 20 seconds left. And down come the hammer blows onto the face of Muhamad Ayman. You couldn't buy a ticket for this one. Sold out. And they are loving it.
He's pushing past, and this is where the fight has been contested, in this side control position.
It's
very impressive, Danny Kingad.
Listen to this crowd, and what a contest.
By way of unanimous decision from the
red corner, Danny Kingad.
Here we have Danny Kingad and Satya Kichagov. Kichagov, the trouble. Trying to pose here, the trouble for Kingad. An aggressive start and a takedown from the King.
Beautiful takedown from Kingad to end up in side control. This is where he loves to be.
Beautiful knee there from Kingad to the side of the head. Side control for the Filipino. House on fire early. Not how Satya Kichagov wanted to start this contest, Mitch.
Yeah, not a good spot for him to be in against Kingad. Kingad loves the ground and pound. He unleashes heavy shots when he gets in the top position, especially in these dominant positions like side control here. Look at him trying to overland those knees, going up over the guard and dropping it straight down on Satya.
Satya Kichagov, a four-stripe blue belt in BJJ under Gilberto Bottiglieri and Luis Finocchio. And he used some of that BJJ now to get out of this predicament. Side control still for the King, Danny Kingad. Looking for firearm control. A very aggressive start from Kingad. Drills another knee. Where does Satya go from here, Mitch?
That's it. He's got an underhook on the right side. So now he can start to scoot his way onto his side. That's what he's doing. Now he's trying to reach for the leg to get back into half guard.
Popping right hand to the top of the head there from Kingad.
Strong Kingad is, has that whizzer on that right hand, just driving Satya down. Now he's got the front headlock, look for more knees. He spins to the back.
Oh, have a look at this from the King! Explosive stuff from Danny Kingad.
Keeps going around. Satya's got to move with him. Kingad has to scramble with him.
He wants the back, he wants the hooks in, he wants to choke out the Bulgarian. My word, what a start here from Danny Kingad. He's going to try and wrap the figure four around the body, trying to fit the breathing of Kichagov.
Kichagov peels the hand off of his neck, gets him out of danger from there. He's on the opposite side. Now he spins around. Oh, puts Kingad on the back now.
Great work there from Kichagov. Now the Bulgarian has top position, got out of the attempted body triangle. Kichagov, can he posture up here? Has some very powerful ground and pound. Predicted he'd try and TKO Kingad via the ground and pound.
He likes that. He's got a nice little short little arms where he's driving those elbows in. Now he's got the overhook on that one side. Let's see what Sotir can do. If he can try and posture up, drop a little bit of ground and pound on his own.
Kingad from the Igorot ethnicity, a group of mountain people known for their warrior spirit. Very evident so far here in the opening round. Kingad working off his back now. 1 foot on the hips for the Filipino. Sprawling down, back to his foot.
Use that foot on the hip very well to push away, create a little space, get back up top.
Roundhouse kick there, Mawashi getting.
Now he's gonna start throwing those baseball bats and legs at Sotir.
6 centimeters shorter is Danny Kingad. Let's see if Kichagov can get those long legs up.
See Kichagov use that reach, use that jab a little bit.
Gotta watch that lead hook of Kingad. It's a ripper. It comes in quick and finds the target, then it gets out. Good sticky jab here from Kichagov. Left hook from Kingad. Kichagov just weaved under in time. High kick. Just whistles past the brow of Kichagov. Beautiful threading jab. There's the use of the reach from Satya Kichagov.
1 minute left in the first round.
Close that distance, getting nice and tight. Nice little leg kick there, but he enters that punching range. Kingad.
Front kick off the back leg from Danny Kingad goes to the inside lead thigh. Kichagov's gonna start throwing a little more now, a little posturing and posing from the Bulgarian. Change levels, maybe drop a body shot off the right hand. It looks for a roundhouse kick. Oh, nicely timed from Kingad. How about that? The support leg taken out from under Kichagov. That was superb. Big outside leg kick again. He stepped right through there. And the high kick, changing levels, Danny Kingad. more kick than a chorus line in the final seconds of this round.
He's really going after that lead leg of Sotir. Very effectively just digging in with those leg kicks.
Into the round, we go to the towers. It turned into a glorified kickboxing contest. And don't forget, April 20 in Manila, the launch of one super series. Smoke and Joe Nadawat versus the great, the legendary, Giorgio Petrosian. Also, Brad Riddell takes on Richard Ursel. Fabio Pinca versus Nong O, and a whole lot more. One super series, April 20 in Manila, is going to be insane. The greatest strikers in the world in one super series.
Michael, don't get ahead of yourself, though. We still got Iron Will coming up. We got March 24 in Bangkok coming up.
Bibiano Fernandez takes on Martin Nguyen. Nguyen looking to become a three, get it a three division champion. Are you serious? It's going to be nuts.
He wants all the belts.
Biggest year ever for one championship, the largest martial arts organization in the world. And look at this crowd inside the magnificent Axiata Arena. And beautiful, stunning, I love.
Go!
Second round of three.
It seems so Kichikov can make some adjustments and slow down Danny Kingad. He's got to use that jab, circle. Don't stand there in front of him. Don't be a stationary target.
See if Kingad can bring in some of those side kicks, the wushu side kicks. Fake there from Kingad. Hunting down, prowling on Sotir Kichikov.
He does have chokes that he likes to go to.
Does the trouble have Kingad in trouble?
It's pretty tight right here, but look at the way Kingad's framing the shoulder off it, turns to the side a little bit, creates a little bit of space. It was impossible to finish right there. Now he lets go of it.
How much energy would that have drained from Kichikov?
It wasn't that much. He didn't really commit to the choke. Danny Kingad immediately started to turn his body to the right side and place that shoulder to create a little bit of space. And so it frees up his neck. Kichikov realized it, let go of it, and it's not going to gas out his arms.
He's still holding the head. He's still holding the head.
You can see he's still holding the head, keeping Danny Kingad away from posturing up and dropping the bombs.
Kichikov back to his feet. Kingad picks him up. Boom! Shakalaka!
Opening, places the legs, and passes the guard, ends up in full side control, Michael.
Crowd love the big takedown from the King. Side control now cuts the hip in. Plenty of options from this position, Mitch, for the King.
Yeah, right now he's just choosing a knee. That's where he seems to like. He likes to get into side control and drop hammers on him. He's using the elbows, using the knees, very short range strikes, just softening up Kichikov. Kichikov's a tough veteran. He's not going to go out like this. He's going to start to create movement, but he's turning the wrong way. Still, he's turning into King. He has to turn the other way.
F-team in the corner of Sotir Kichikov is shouting instructions to the Bulgarian. Another knee from Kingad, keeping busy, working over Kichikov.
Good job by Kichikov to get back up to his feet. Threaten that single leg, stood back up. Here come the knees.
Oh, the hard end! He went for the meet and greet. And now we're back to kickboxing range. A fake there from Kingad. Outside leg kick turns the knee of Kichikov. Those thunderous leg kicks for that common peroneal nerve. Body shots. Looking for the bread basket. In goes upstairs. Just beating Kichikov to the kick and the punch at every level is Danny Kingad. And again, a right hook. This is Kingad firing on all cylinders. What a display from the youngster from the Philippines. Kichikov needs to find another game plan here. Needs to mix it up. What do you suggest the Bulgarian does, Dragon?
You can just see the way that Kitchikov's letting him pressure him back. See how he's starting to move forward now? I like that strategy. Start to put pressure on Kingad. Don't let Kingad get comfortable and start dropping these big shots. Look at that hook. There's so much intensity thrown with each one of his strikes. He's from Baguio. His conditioning is second to none up there training at altitude. Kingad could do this all night long.
And again, Danny Kingad more hooks than a Pirates convention. 1 minute remaining here in the second round. It's been a great round for the King.
We can see Kitchikov's always on his back foot. He's always backing up. I liked it when he was pushing forward. Put Kingad on his back foot, make him react to it. Kitchikov goes for the takedown, but a heavy sprawl by Kingad. Sacrifice there from Kingad. Doesn't work out well, so well.
Kitchikov, top position, half guard. Chance for him to do some damage. 30 seconds on the clock in the second round of three.
In the second round.
Tries to drop the knee, tried to pin the arm. I feel there of Kingad. Kingad back to his feet. Kitchikov right on top of him, Mitch.
We're starting to see some aggressive Kitchikov. Maybe there's a little bit of urgency coming from Kitchikov's corner. He needs to start pushing it.
Hawking knees to the outside right thigh from Danny Kingad. Goes for wrist control. Kitchikov. Final seconds of this round. Jumps into the guard. Tried for a final submission right before the bell.
A little bit of a flying triangle there. I like it. Look at that beautiful left counter hook from Kingad. Comes over with the right hand, slides under, weaves to one side, goes for the takedown, but got his head caught, and that's where Kitchikov caught him in the guillotine. But then Kingad picks him up, sends him for the ride. What'd you call that? Boom, shakalaka takedown right there. Beautifully done by Kingad. But Kingad is just easing his way and really just getting almost an insurmountable lead at this point. Do you think Kitchikov's got enough left in the tank to turn it up and get the win?
He's a wily veteran, Sotir Kitchikov. He's got many tricks up his sleeve and perhaps a couple that Kingad hasn't seen before. But can he close down the youth, the exuberance, the speed of Danny Kingad? Third and final round inside the beautiful Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It's one championship vision to victory wherever you're watching in 136 countries. We hope you're enjoying the largest martial arts organization in the world. Right there from Kitchikov.
Kingad shook at his hands and almost took up a different little sort of wushu style stance there. Brings his hands back up to a more conventional boxing stance. Good, I like how he attacks the legs, inside leg now. Was the outside leg, now he's going to the inside leg.
Kitchikov goes to the outside lead thigh, trying to attack those quadriceps. Beautiful sticky jab there from Kingad, then sprawls out. Nice takedown defense from the King. Up and over the shoulder almost there from Kitchikov.
See, Kitchikov didn't give up on it. He continually attacked, kept going for it, got the takedown. Now he's got Kingad on his backside.
Trying to find the choke here, Sotir Kitchikov. Kitchikov, he can never write him off. He won't fly the white flag. Always tricks up the Bulgarian sleeve.
And it's hard when Kingad is going in for these takedowns. He keeps his head so high. Beautiful technique. Right into the armpit. Nice and high. Looking up. And that's how Sotir's able to try to get the leg, but he's not able to finish because Kingad's head is so high.
Nice head movement there from Danny Kingad to avoid the punches. Roundhouse kick to the midsection from the Filipino. Overhand right from Kingad. Right hand down the tube from Sotir Kitchikov. Kingad very vibrant, bouncing up and down on the balls of his feet. The more flat-footed here, Sotir Kitchikov. Good front kick from Kingad. They clinch up against the cage. Where does Kingad go from here?
Kingad's got a front headlock. Look for the knees now.
Let's go. 2 minutes 45 remaining in the third and final round. What has Sotir Kichkov got left in his bag of tricks? What's he got left in the gas tank?
He's kind of weaving his lunging in there with these shots. Now he's going for a takedown. Like how he did it up against the cage, though, Kingad's been able to stop a lot of his double legs by sprawling, and he's not able to sprawl when he's up against the cage. Sotir was able to interlock his legs and get him down.
Top position here for Sotir Kichkov. Fourth appearance for Kichkov in the championship. He's been a finisher for most of his career. 10 of his 13 wins, he stopped his opponent. Can he stop Kingad here with a rear naked choke, perhaps?
He's got the back, but he's a little bit high. You can see he's got the arm trapped on Kingad's left side, but he's got to kind of shrug his way back down. It's going to be hard for him to finish, but he's starting to work his way down a little bit. Choke might be there. Oh, my God. Maybe Shimada didn't like something there. I think somebody was holding on to a glove.
We mentioned earlier about this being the first time that Kingad has competed outside the Philippines. It doesn't look like it's fazed him at all, Mitch.
Not at all. He's a high-level martial artist with so much experience in his corner. Belagon, Panario, Foliang, just world champion after world champion. And giving him advice, grooming this young man to be the best martial artist he can be. And that's what we're seeing here tonight. But right now, he's in a bad spot. Sotir could finish. He's got some rear naked chokes on his resume.
The body triangle, the figure four, will make it hard for Danny Kingad to get a full run of air. It's a controlling position. You get a good look there at the body triangle of Sotir Kichkov. Under a minute remaining in the third and final round now. The Bulgarian in control, wrapping off the right hands and the elbows now. How does Kingad get out of this, Mitch?
Sotir's got the hand pinned on that one side, so he can't. All he can do is cover up and protect. But Sotir needs to go for a finish. He's doing the right thing by going to that side. See where the body triangle is? You need to go to the side. You need to put your pressure on the side where the foot is to alleviate a little bit of the squeeze from the body triangle. He was there. Now he's, I think he's going back to it. Now he's got his hips against that closed side, that entangled side of the body triangle. And Sotir needs a finish at this point. I don't think he's got enough in this area to do something because Kingad's striking back.
Kingad indeed trying to stay busy, even though he's got that boa constrictor of a body triangle wrapped around his midsection. All hard from Danny Kingad. A great run home there for Sotir Kichkov.
By unanimous decision from the blue corner, Danny Kingad.
And the king has done it. Is the Southern Eagle, and here we go. Huge Filipino community in Macau, China, and they have turned out in their droves for Danny Kingad tonight, Mitch.
I don't know who got the bigger ovation, the Filipino or the Chinese athlete.
Southpaw stance, switching to orthodox, then back to southpaw. Mahalbin, jab two from Kingad. Mahalbin gets under it for a single leg. What aggression!
Rack and roundhouse kick as the battle rages on. Good takedown for Mahalbin to snatch on the back. So quick.
Mahalbin hoping to get back into the winner's circle after losing his last contest. Before that, he was riding a magnificent seven-match streak. Palliser back here, tries to put a hook in. Does Mahalbin. What's Danny Kingad looking for here, Dragon?
Danny Kingad, he's trying to separate the hands. You can see that Mahalbin has triangled that leg. He's trapped one leg. He's trying to get both hooks in. So now he's got both legs wrapped around Kingad's legs. You can see he's got a Kimura grip where he's got his own wrist and he's got the wrist of Mahalbin, but he's trying to use that maybe to create a little bit of a scramble to change positions. Mahalbin's a little bit low on the back of Kingad. Kingad's rolling, but as he's rolling, he's allowing Mahalbin to get these hooks, to get his legs wrapped around Kingad's legs.
I think the chant going up sounds like it's for Mahalbin here in Studio City. They are very loud. And still you see Kingad looking for submission on the left arm of the Southern Eagle.
You can't really submit him in that position. It would be almost impossible to throw on a Kimura from there, but he could use that to really separate the hands and maybe sweep or use it to change positions.
Rolled through again there from the King, Danny Kingad. Mahalbin refusing to give up on that arm of Kingad.
Mahalbin's got a vice-like grip around the body of Kingad. Kingad can't separate the grip. Now he's going to use it to roll. Now he's gonna, Kingad might end up on top if he can move that right arm over the head.
How about that crowd roar for a prelim contest? Kingad and Mahalbin, Studio City. In Macau, China, going crazy for these two.
Nice reversal from Kingad. He's going to end up in side mount here if Mahalbin's not careful.
Reverse sold out a couple of days ago. Still, the great crowd continues to file. Inside control now for Danny Kingad. Can he drop the elbow from here? Yes, he can. And the knees. Here comes the King. Aggression now from the King. Drills the knee to the side of the head.
A little top control from Kingad. The way that he's positioning and holding down the national wrestling champion, Mahalbin, is very impressive. You know Team Lakay has put in some serious work in the grappling department. Look how he's isolated that right arm of Mahalbin. He's laced underneath it. Drops a little bit of ground and pound as Mahalbin scrambles out.
The aggression from Mahalbin. I should say from Danny Kingad. And the back of the foot behind him. Big explode for Kingad. What a round for the King. Backs up Mahalbin.
Mahalbin shaking out those arms. That was a lot of time he spent with those arms locking together.
Wild uppercut and a leaping right hook. A ferocious first round. Mahalbin's got to find a way to get Kingad on his back. Fakes there from the Chinese athlete. Step across inside, thank it.
Mahalbin staying just out of Kingad's punching range, but he could attack the legs with some low kicks here.
Oh, the big overhand right, boom! Straight nice to the forehead there from Mahalbin. And Kingad winds up a roundhouse kick to the waist. Goes a little higher up off the lead leg. What a round. Both men pulling out all the stops, turning back here. Trying to channel his inner Kevin Ballignon. And Mahalbin returns the favor. End of the first round, we go to the towels. What a ripper! Of utter martial arts action from these two athletes.
That big roundhouse is what started off, and Mahalbin slid under, but then you can see Kingad defending well, but this is that scramble. Mahalbin does a beautiful toss, ends up on the back, and that's where they spent most of that round, but Kingad was able to reverse the position. Look at him get up, but Mahalbin was able to get on top.
To MD Ruffy watching in Delhi, India. Inside leg there from Danny Kingad. The red trunks flying the Filipino flag. Another step across inside, thigh kick. Overhand right counter from Mahalbin.
Kingad seems to have found his kicking range. He's really able to put a lot of this just distance and separate the two. He's not landing a lot of punches. Mahalbin's doing a good job of evading those, but his kicks are worth scoring for him to stand up.
Turning back in from Mahalbin. What we heard from the crowd there, that was the chant for Kingad. It went up after another group of fans started the chant for Mahalbin. There was a lone man shouting out Bin, and then a whole group of the crowd shouted out Mahal really loud. It was great. The atmosphere here, Mitch, for the prelims, are you serious? How nuts is this?
That's this card. That is the card ONE Championship has put together here in Macau.
Another sellout. Good front kick there from Mahalbin. Oh, that was tricky. It looked like a front kick. switched up to a reverse question mark kick from Danny Kingad. Outside leg kick. He's got to be careful, Kingad. Every time he's thrown that leg kick, Mahalbin's trying to time the overhand right counter. That being the power side of the Southern Eagle. Jousting the chant again, and this time it's Danny Kingad's chant that wins out here. A match in the ring, and there's a shouting match in the crowd. I love it. Good outside crescent kick there from Danny Kingad.
Kingad has just found his range with the kicks, and he's doing a lot of scoring with these shots. Inside leg kick.
Recovery time here for Mahalbin.
He's
allowed up to 5 minutes for recovery due to the illegal groin strike from Danny Kingad. Big hello to Ricardo Garcia watching from Laguna in the Philippines. Big hello to Maxibet Malik watching from Somalia. To Tigun Ismail watching from Malaysia. And Mitch, talk us through this. There it is. Looked like a high inside thigh. He just clipped the bottom of the cup of Mahalbin.
Yeah, I don't think I need to talk you through that, Michael. You did a pretty good job.
So recovery time here for the Southern Eagle. To Danny Bernardo watching in Riyadh, and to Skinny Young watching from Madagascar. Truly fans from all over the world watching our prelims live on Facebook, live on Twitter, live on the One Championship app.
Show of sportsmanship as Kingad apologizes. Goes right back to it though. Goes right back to this. Says I'm sorry and does it again. Completely accidental.
In all fairness to Kingad, he has been looking for that inside thigh kick, but you do run the risk when you throw that technique of going a little too high and clipping your opponent south of the border, as Kingad did there for the second time. Very pained Southern Eagle. This crowd inside Studio City in Macau, China, split right down the center for these two men. Now, Mahalbin is allowed 5 minutes for medical examination and recovery. If he is unable to continue, an official decision will be given. Mitch, if we went to a decision right now, would you give the contest to Danny Kingad or would you give it to Mahalbin if we went there right now?
Right now, especially with the strikes that Kingad has been landing with these leg shots, you know, obviously the two low blows not in the picture, but
there's no doubt, you can see by the footwork there, the way he steps across, it was an inside leg kick, a step across inside leg kick. It's a Muay Thai technique, but it may have just been the outside of the foot just clipping the bottom of the protector that Mahalbin is wearing.
Our athlete is going to continue, and the contest resumes.
But Mitch, we're okay to go on here.
Here we go. At this point, you asked me the question, who would I give the match to? I gotta say maybe a slight advantage to Kingad, but there was that back control from Mahalbin, but it is a razor close match at this point. Go. See if Kingad changes his tactics.
What about the inside leg kick?
Get it right there.
Goes the side kick. It's a Team Lakay Wushu specialty, the side kick. Left hook there from Mahalbin. Kingad, jab two down the center corridor. Good right cross from Mahalbin. Kingad goes for the bread basket. Missed the target. Nice footwork from the Southern Eagle. Inside leg. Finding range on it now is Danny Kingad. Outside leg kick, well timed. Gotta be careful again. As I said, Mahalbin is trying to time the overhand right counter off the outside leg kick from Danny Kingad.
Yeah, but Kingad is beating up that lead leg of Mahalbin, and that's gonna affect that move right there. His double leg isn't gonna be the same as Kingad starts to hammer on that lead leg. Mahalbin's going to lose a little bit of that pop, lose a little bit of that explosion, but doesn't matter if you catch the leg. Let's see if he can suck it in. Yep. Oh, good reversal by Kingad.
This crowd going bananas again for Kingad and Mahalbin. Bellinger back now from the Southern Eagle. Can he somehow find a way to get Kingad down, put Kingad on his back, and launch that ground and pound?
just see how fast Mahal Bin can transition to the back. One minor mistake and Mahal Bin is all over it. Now he's jumped on the back. He's got one hook in. Oh, he might slide off the back though. Oh,
oh, Danny Kingad tries to slip on a submission. But Mahal Bin out of trouble with the victory fight.
1 minute left.
This crowd is electric here in Macau, China.
Starting to buckle. Nice push kick from the rear side.
Outside leg kick from Kingad. Oh, there's the right hand. Smack bang to the kisser from Mahal Bin.
That's his best weapon, that tiny clever hand right.
Two-punch combination, Kingad. There's the overhand right from Mahal Bin. Belly to back now from the Chinese martial artist. The aggression from these two young athletes. Phenomenal.
Oh, big knees from Mahal Bin.
Knees to the hamstring, to that sciatic nerve. Mahal Bin bringing the round home strongly. Two down and one to go. To Ezenwa Chikawado from the Ivory Coast and Ricky Sabuya from the Philippines and Tolotot from Cambodia.
There's a little bit of the leg work from Kingad, but then again, that was that timed overhand right. Here's the scramble as Danny Kingad tries to lock in what looked like kind of a Darce choke, but he's missing the arm on that one, so it doesn't really have the same sort of positioning that he's got. The alternative grip guillotine. But good round for both these guys. Mahal Bin did a lot of damage there from the back, driving those knees into the thighs. But Kingad, again, he was working the leg. You know, didn't get a yellow card for the two low shots, so that's not going to affect scoring. But good job from both these guys in a highly entertaining bout.
Third and final round of what has been an absolute cracker between these two amazing young athletes. Who will dig deep and bring it home strongly for the final 5 minutes?
Final round! Go!
Inside leg kick from Kingad.
Kingad to go back to those kicks, attack the leg, and look for Mahal Bin to throw that big right hand, transitioning into one of his takedowns as he tries to catch the leg.
Overhand right from Mahal Bin, gets a takedown. Can he put Kingad flat in his back here? This is where Mahal Bin wants to be. He works so well from this top position match.
Yeah, he does. Kingad's got a scramble though. He's got one butterfly hook in. Now he's got to create, he's got the other foot on the hip, trying to create a little bit of space. Trying to attack the arm there on Mahal Bin's left side, but Mahal Bin's keeping it nice and tight, not allowing Kingad to sneak in.
Mahal Bin, top position, butterfly hooks here from Danny Kingad. Chance go up for Mahal Bin. Now for Kingad, listen to this.
Mahal Bin's got a heavy top game. He really excels here. He's trying to step over the legs, but Kingad's doing a good job of maintaining the guard.
Chance once more for Mahal Bin. The field time may be ticking away from the Chinese athlete. The aggression shown by Danny Kingad in that second round particularly.
Second round was good for Kingad. The first round was very close, but you know, Mahal Bin's got to do something maybe a little bit extraordinary here, a little bit more damage, try to pass the guard of Kingad, end up in a dominant position. We got 3 minutes to go, and that's a lifetime in there.
Trying to line up the knee, blocked by the forearm of Kingad, who glances towards his corner. Still half guard position for the Southern Eagle, now spins around. Kingad locking onto that right leg, grasps the hands.
Good job from Kingad to reverse. Beautiful to end up in side control. Very minor mistake for Mahal Bin to not sprawl out heavy and give Kingad control of that leg. And Kingad was able to sweep him over and end up in top.
This version of Danny Kingad tonight is phenomenal. Drills in a couple of knees off the right leg. Side control for the King.
One, two.
And the elbow. And again, this crowd going absolutely bananas here in Studio City, Macau, China. Danny Kingad, if he gets a submission or gets a knockout, will bring the house down. Here come the knees from the Southern Eagle.
Again, Kingad gives up his back, allows Muhamad Bin to secure the back and look for him to drop those knees. Interesting choice to get restarted in the center of the cage as he tries to roll out. How Bin's got one leg trapped. Kingad's trying to fight it off, going for a possible knee bar of his own. Yes, that's in. That's caught. He's a little bit too high. A little bit too high to finish.
It's Tiffany inside Studio City. Now the tide turns. It's Mahal Bin's chance.
Mahal Bin went for a guillotine, but Kingad swiveled around to the side to end up in side control. Now 1 minute to go, and it could be anybody's game at this point.
In the final round.
Just crazy scenes here inside of Studio City. Under 45 seconds remains in this contest. Wherever you're watching around the world, who do you have it for? The King, Danny Kingad, or Mahal Bin, the Southern Eagle?
Mahal Bin scrambles well. He moves very well from that bottom position to reverse. Kingad going for a guillotine. This is a very important pivotal 20 seconds. Let's see if Mahal Bin can shift the judges' persuasion in his favor.
Mahal Bin trying for something in the final seconds. They're all tied up like a ball of twine. We're going to hear the bell any moment now. This has been something outstanding. This has been something phenomenal. This is one championship.
By unanimous decision from the Blue Corner.
Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.